Hi, and welcome to the second episode of the comparison series, where I compare real-life 4x4 driving lessons to driving in the Camel Trophy mod. This episode will be about driving in mud, and to tell you the truth, I won't cover the topic completely, as there are different kinds of mud that may require different techniques, but I will try my best. Also, the muffled voice man who gives all the advice does not give enough credit to the mud. Because in the game, in my opinion, the mud is what makes it different and special. The ability to deform and push around all that dirt in the game was the thing that really made Spintires interesting and attractive for me in the first place. Okay, enough with the daydreaming. What is the real life lesson?
A muddy surface requires a slightly higher speed than a dry one. Wherever possible, stay in the tracks of previous vehicles. Try to avoid steering into any slight slides in order to correct them, because the vehicle will normally stay on course, despite a certain amount of side slippage.
Sensible advice, and basically what it means is that when you are driving in mud, do not stop and try to keep constant speed. Try not to spin the tires despite the title of the game, but you and I know that this is near impossible and you will get stuck sooner or later. The mud physics have had some adjustments in the mod to make the game more challenging. So what can you do to get out of the hole you just dug while trying to save fuel and drive without the diff lock enabled? Using the winch is sensible, but what if there is no winch point in close proximity? First of all, stop spinning the tires as soon as you see that the car is digging in. Full power might work in top gear and in base game, but not in the mod. Key to success is force acceleration. Also, you should know in which direction the ground is harder or drier. Carefully apply power in that direction and try to avoid turning the wheel, as higher steering angle also increases resistance. Stop and drive around the mess you just created and never try to power through it, unless you want to get stuck again. There is another technique that is very common in real-life situations. I just call it the swing effect, but it might go by another name. One way how to do it is to use force acceleration and switch from low-range gear to reverse quite quickly, and the car or truck will start to swing gently and there will be a point when you will be able to drive off. I've seen it work in game, but this is just for demonstration, as other ways would have worked as well. Also, I would like to demonstrate that force acceleration works not only for getting out of sticky situations, but also for avoiding them. Firstly, I will try to drive through a particularly nasty piece of road using just force acceleration, and you can see that slowly and steadily, the Land Rover digs through and gets to the other side. And now I will attempt to cross the same piece of road by using just the W key. And as you can see, I got stuck in the end and had to use the winch to get out. Of course, force acceleration won't help in all situations, and sometimes you will have to use the rescue truck. Generally, if the mud is above front and back bumpers, you should start looking for a winch point or ask for help to your mates. Keep testing to find out what works best for you and just be patient.
If you steer lightly through the mud at constant speed, you will discover that the only effect on the vehicle is a mud bath, easily removable by a good wash.
Yeah, right. Anyway, thanks for watching, give it a like, and see you in the next episode. Bye!